these drugs, they used to prepare the that patra pinda potalis veda. Is patra potalis veda. So which is definitely helpful in the like vata vyadis like pakshagata, ardita. So there they used to do for swedana karma. Okay, first they used to do snehara karma, that is abhyanga. Then after that they used to use the swedana patra pinda sveda. Okay, so definitely it will overcome the conditions. So the indications is vata, kaphaja disorders, and katishula, gradrasi, pakshagata, and avabhauka. So this is one of the questions they asked in the examination. So among them, Agnimanta is one. So this is the plant, Agnimanta, especially in South India. In South India, we are using this plant. So there is another variety of Agnimanta. There is a Clerodendron phlomoides. Clerodendron phlomoides. That is mainly they are using in the North India. In the North India, they are using Clerodendron phlomoides. They are using as an Agnimanta in North India, whereas in South India, we are using this Premna integrifolia or Premna serratifolia. In South India, it is abundantly available. So even some peoples, they are saying it as like an Kiraliya Agnimanta. Even the recent scholars, they used to say it as Kiraliya Agnimanta. So in this South India, this drug is abundantly available. Okay, so this is the picture of the plant Agnimanta. So the basonym of Agnimanta, Agnim mantnati deepanatvat. Agnim mantnati deepanatvat. Manthana. So Agnim mantnati deepanatvat. So when you do the manthana karma, that is like churning or like rubbing. When you, that is especially the dried sticks of Agnimanta, when you rubbed each other, so it produces the Agni. So that is, since from the Veda Kala, there also they used to use for to making the Homa Havana there, which enhances, which easily they used to do the Agnivardhana is going to be takes place. Even the some peoples in the rural areas, the peoples, they used to collect for like as in fuel, they are using it as in fuel in making, in cooking the foods. Okay. Agnim mantnati deepanatvat. In 2-3 aspects they used to describe. So one aspect, when you administer internally, which stimulates the Agni. When you administer internally, the preparations like kashaya, kvata, or any of the preparations. So those the preparations they used to ignite. They used to stimulate the Agni. When you stick, you can take two, the dried sticks of Agnimanta, you can rub each other. So they used to produce the Agni. So in that aspect they used to say, okay, so when two dried sticks of Agnimanta rubbed each other will produce the fire, and when administered internally it stimulates the digestive fire. That is Agnim mantnati deepanatvat. Okay, so the botanical source for Agnimanta, that is Premna integrifolia. There is a one the committee, CCRAS, that is Central Council for Research in Ayurveda and Siddha, which is situated in New Delhi. So in 1999, they have added even the Premna serratifolia also can be taken as the botanical source for Agnimanta. In 1999, they used to say Premna serratifolia is also taken as one of the botanical source for Agnimanta. Premna integrifolia. Integri means whole, entire. Folia means leaves. The leaves are having entire margin. The leaves are having entire margin. And Premna serratifolia means serrati means having serrated margins. Folia means leaves. The leaves are having serrated margins. So that type of the drugs they used to say as Premna serratifolia and Premna integrifolia. I will show the pictures. They will come to know. The around the one third part of the lamina. I think you will come across with the drug like Jyotishpati. There also the same the morphology. The one third part of the leaf or the lamina, which is having the serrated margins. In the same way, here also it is having the serrated margins. As it is belongs to the family Verbenaceae family. So the drugs which are belongs to, already we have discussed the drugs of Verbenaceae family. That is with, I think we have discussed about Gambhari, which is also belongs to the Verbenaceae family. Okay, so the detailed drugs which are mentioned under Verbenaceae family are like Agnimanta and Bharangi, Gambhari, Nirgundi. There are four drugs: Agnimanta, Bharangi, Gambhari, Nirgundi. These are the four detailed drugs which are comes under Verbenaceae family. And already I have mentioned that the characteristic feature of Verbenaceae family, if you see all these four drugs like Agnimanta, Bharangi, Nirgundi and Gambhari, so the young shoots which are having a quadrangular stem, young shoots, whereas the old shoots, it becomes, or the old branches becomes, they are cylindrical in shape. The old branches are cylindrical in shape, whereas the young shoots are quadrangular in nature. So this is one of the characteristic feature of Verbenaceae family. And one of the non-detailed drugs which are belongs to the Verbenaceae family is a Shaka, that is a Tectona grandis. Mainly there, we are using the stem, that is the main trunk, that is for one, the foot, which is around about 3,000 to 5,000 rupees for one foot, the one gana foot. So that for mainly they are using for in preparing the furniture and all those things. There is a Shaka Tectona grandis. So vernacular names in Hindi it is called Arani. In Hindi it is called Arani. In English it is called Igud. In English it is called Igud. And in Kannada, Naravalu or Teggigida. Kannada dali Naravalu atava Teggigida. Okay. So this is the vernacular name of Agnimanta. So next we'll move to the Ganas according to Charaka. So Achara Charaka mentioned it under Anuvasanopaga Mahakashaya, Shotahara Mahakashaya, and Shita Prashamana Mahakashaya. Anuvasanopaga Shotahara Shita Prashamana. So what is meant by Anuvasana? So especially as we used to say, that is Basti as an Ardha Chikitsa in case of Vatavyadi. Basti as Ardha Chikitsa in case of Vatavyadis. So for in case of Basti, like we used to prescribe Anuvasana Basti, Astapana Basti. So Anuvasana is a Ruksha Basti. Sorry, Anuvasana is a Sneha Basti. There we used to use, that is particularly which is indicated in case of Vatavyadi, that is Snigdha, by using the different types of Tailas. So these are drugs, the Anuvasanopaka Dravyas, which enhances the potency of the Bastis. So the drugs like Rasna, as you all know, the Rasna, Vataharanam Sreshtam, Rasna, Vataharanam Sreshtam, even Eranda, that is Eranda Moolam, Vataharanam Sreshtam, Rushya, Vataharanam Sreshtam, and Rasna is Sreshta Vatashamaka also. So Rasna, Surasa, Suradharu, Rasna, Suradharu, Bilva, Madanafala, Shatapushpa, Rushchira, Punarnava, Swadhamstra, Agnimanta, Shonyaka. So these are the 10 drugs which are having, which enhances the potency of the this Basti Dravyas, Anuvasanopaka Mahakashayas. Then Shotahara Mahakashaya, as you all know, this is very well. So mainly Shotam Haratiti, Shotaharam, the drugs one which reduces the Shota. I think in Charaka Sutrasthana, there you are going to come with the name of the chapter is Trivida Shoti Adhyaya. There are different types of the Shotas, depending upon the causative factors. So there is a Vataja Shota, Pittaja Shota, Kafaja Shota, Sandipataja Shota, or like Agantaja Shota. Depending upon the different causative factors, Shota is going to be formed, like the inflammation, where there will be swelling, where there will be a pain. So to reduce that, to overcome that, the Shota, so Acharya Charaka mentioned the 10 drugs. So that is, as you all know, it is a combination of Laghu Panchamula and Brahat Panchamula. That is Bilva Agnimanta Shonyaka, Patla, Kashmarya, Shalaparani, Krishnaparani, Brahati, Kantakarika. So these are the 10 drugs which are useful in case of to treat the conditions called Shota. Okay, and Shita Prashamana Mahakashaya, that also we have discussed in the last class while discussing about Agaru. That is Shitam Prashamayati Iti Shita Prashamanam. That is Agaru Agniman. The drugs like sorry. Tagara agaru dhanyaka shrungavera bhutika vacha kantakari agnimanta shonyaka pippali. So these are the 10 drugs which are useful in case of to reduce the shita. That is shita prashamana mahakashaya. And according to Shushruta, that is brahat panchamula gana. That is, it is a combination of 5 types of drugs in which the swarup of the drug is bigger in size and there the mula they are going to use like bilva, agnimanta, shonyaka, patla, kashmarya. So these are the 5 drugs in which mula were using. That is, and the varunadigana and veera tharvadigana. Shushruta mentioned under brahat panchamula, varunadigana and veera tharvadigana. Next, we'll move to the synonyms of agnimanta. So, based on the appearance, based on the swarupa, how it looks. That is ganikarika, ganikarika, based on the swarupa. Gane samuhe bava prasaranti va. Gane samuhe bava prasaranti va. Means like gane samuhe. That is, it looks like a bushy appearance. And observe yes, so this is the picture like a gana rupika. So gana rupika means gane samuhe. So it looks like a bushy appearance. If you see this picture, so there is a main trunk is absent and there are numerous branches that too they used to originate from the single root. That is definitely it comes under like ekamula sanghata jata. So based on that characters, almost all the characters, it is same. That is absence of the main trunk and there are many branches they used to arise from the ground level and many branches that too from single root. From the single root, many branches and that too from the ground level. So all the characters, it shows about that is Gana Samuhe or you can select Gulma. Okay, so Ganika Arika. That is Ganesune Bhava Prasarantiva. So, which looks like bushy appearance. Gana Ganikarika, which looks like a bushy appearance. Nadheyi, based on the availability. Nadheyi, Nadhyam Bhava, means one which grows in the banks of the rivers. Especially, we used to consider Agnimanta, that is in South Indian states, especially where the rainfall will be less. In those areas, the plant is abundantly grown, but the Acharya Bhava Mishra, he used to say, as given the synonym as a Nadheyi. So, Nadheyi means the plants one which grows on the banks of the rivers. In the banks of the rivers, Nadi Dande. So, in that particular place, the plant is commonly available. Nadheyi, Nadhyam Bhava. Okay. Sri Parna. See the name Sri Parni. That is, we have discussed. One of the drugs which belongs to the Verbenaceae family, that is Gambhari. Gambhari is having the synonym as a Sri Parani, Badra Parani. That is based on the leaves. The leaves are beautiful. The leaves are attractive. Here this is Sri Parna. So this is one of the vaivavasya question or you may get in neat examinations. Sri Parna. Sri Parna is a synonym of Agnimanta. Sri Parani is a synonym of Gambhari. There are so many drugs which are having the synonym as Sri Parni or Sri Parna. So you can go through the Bhavaprakasha Nigantu, the last 23rd Varga, Vivida Namartha Varga. There you will get the different drugs. Sri Yuktani Parnani Ashyaha Iti. That is, the leaves are beautiful. The leaves are attractive in nature. It is Sri Parna based on the leaves. Ketuhu patakeva pushpamanjari. So this synonym ketuhu, which gives, this is specifically for to denote about inflorescence, how the inflorescence they used to appear. Patakeva pushpamanjari, the inflorescence are like I think already come to know about Corimbo's inflorescence in case of Ashoka. In the same way, so this is also a Corimbo's inflorescence, where there will be a cluster of flowers, like umbel inflorescence, like umbrella. So I will show the picture while explaining about the morphology. Ketuhu, patakeva, Pushpamanjari. Then based on the actions, Jaya Jayanti. Jaya Jayanti. Jayati Roghan. Jayati Roghan. One which overcomes many diseases. One which overcomes many diseases. It is called as Jaya Jayanti. And Vaijayantika, there is another synonym. Actually, I have not mentioned in this slide. Vaijayantika, that denotes about the inflorescence. Vaijayantika, that denotes about inflorescence. Ketuhu and Vaijayantika, two synonyms based on the inflorescence. And based on the actions, Jaya Jayanti, that is Jayati Rogan, one which overcomes the diseases. Aranika, Agni Rupena Prayujyamanaha. Even the vernacular names, that is in Hindi, we used to say like Arani. Even some of the classical textbook also, they used to mention like Arani. Arani or Aranika, that is based on the actions. It is a synonym of Agnimanta. That is Agni Rupena Prayujyamanaha. It is using, that is like Agni Rupena, as like, which is similar like Agni properties. Means one which enhances the potency, one which increases the, or one which ignite the fire, one which stimulates the fire. That is Agni Rupena Prayujyamanaha. We are using, as we are using in case of Homa Havana, so to increase the Agni, we are using this drug as in fuel. We are using the common peoples, they are using. So when you use externally, when you use internally, so both there, it is going to act like Agni Rupena Prayujyamanaha. And Vatagni. Vatari is a synonym of Eranda. So here Vatagni, one which cures the Vata Vyadi. As in case of Patra Pinda Patali Sveda, that is specifically indicated in case of the Vata Vikaras, one which reduces, one which overcomes the conditions called Vata Vyadi. That is in case of Ruddha or vitiation of the Vata. So you can use such type of drugs. Okay. Specifically, like Moola is a useful part. Even the leaves are also going to act as an Vata Shamaka. And Tharkari. Tharkari, that is a common name. They used to say commonly, they used to say the type of Agnimanta. So in Shushruta Samhita, Varunadi Gana, there he used to explain Agnimanta and Tharkari. The two types. Types they have mentioned, but both drugs they have mentioned. But in, if you see the Bhavaprakash Nigantu, he has not mentioned any types of Agnimanta. Mentioned only the Agnimanta. Nigantukaras, they used to say Tharkari and Agnimanta, they are the types of Agnimanta. They are the types of Agnimanta. I will see the botanical sources for Agnimanta and Tharkari while explaining about the types of Agnimanta. Okay, so this is the picture or the Swarupa of Agnimanta. So usually in some text, they used to mention it as like a medium-sized tree, small or medium-sized tree. But what we are getting in South India, so this is the Agnimanta, this is the botanical source, that is Premana integrifolia. So this is a big bushy-like appearance. So as the main trunk is absent and there are so many branches, they used to arise from the ground level. So because of these characters, we used to include this drug under shrub, gulma. So you can write the Agnimanta, it is a big shrub. It is a big shrub. But in the textbook, they have mentioned as it is a tree. But there is no such character we used to find in, if you want to select a tree. That is, there should be a presence of single trunk. That trunk should be hard, woody. But here, there is no single trunk. There is no main trunk is absent. So based on that character, you can say Agnimanta is a big shrub. Okay. So this is the Swarupa. So here, it may be around about 10 to 15 feet height. Even more than 15 feet height, we are getting. So this is naturally, this is cultivated area where they used to collect the plants for the preparation of the medicines. So this is another picture which shows about the Swarupa of the plant, which is a bushy appearance, like Gulmavat. So this is the plant. You can observe the branches and the leaves. Leaf and the branches you can observe in this picture. So this is another picture of Agnimanta. So also in this picture you can observe along with the inflorescence. So here clearly you can observe about the leaf, different pictures of Agnimanta. Yes. So this is the branch where this is the leaf. And this green expanded part called the lamina. So the lamina is not dissected or not divided. So that's why we used to say it is a simple leaf. Type of leaf is simple. So here you can clearly observe this is one leaf. So this is one leaf. So type of leaf is simple, and you can observe here this is entire margin, and here it starts the dissecting. The lamina is going to dissect and form somewhat like the serrate margins. Serrate margin. So the 1/3 part of the lamina. So this much. So this much of the lamina is dissected. That is the margins of the lamina is dissected. Whereas the one. So this 3/4 part of the lamina is entire. This the 3/4 part of the lamina is entire. It is having entire margin, and this in the apex part it is dissected. Okay. Next, the arrangement of the leaf. So you can observe the arrangement of the leaf is opposite. So if you compare with this, this is opposite decusset, right angle to each other. If you the two arrangement of the leaf, if you observe, that is right angle to each other, and here. The apex, you can say, so this is the apex. It is sharply acuminate. The apex is sharply acuminate. That is a tail-like structure. Very sharply, suddenly narrows into a forms a tail-like structure. So based on this, we used to say as an sharply acuminate, not acute, acuminate apex. Okay. So here also you can observe the some of the serrate margins and entire margins. And regarding the shape of the lamina, it is broadest at the middle. It is broadest at the middle and gradually tapering towards the base as well as the apex. So this you can say like elliptic, and even sometimes like ovate, elliptic margin. So elliptic shape of the lamina, and even sometimes even the oblong, the character the margins of the lamina is parallel. So that also comes here. You can observe the margins of the lamina is parallel, that also oblong. So here see the